I welcome all dear students to this e-learning module. Myself, Dr. Pramod Bhagwan Thakur. I am working as an assistant professor at Department of Chemistry, Rajshikshan Sanstha, Mahatma Phule Arts, Science and Commerce College, Panvel, District Raigad, Mumbai, Maharashtra, India. You are watching the third video of the e-learning module entitled Introduction to Cosmetic Analysis. In this module, you are going to learn about estimation of constituents of face powder. In detail, you are going to learn the reagents required for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium present in face powder and procedure for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium in face powder. So here first we'll see reagent required for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium in face powder. The first reagent is sulfuric precipitate. It is 80 gram of ammonium carbonate and 90 ml ammonium hydroxide mixed in 375 ml of water. To that 475 ml of alcohol is added. So we get the sulfuric precipitant. Second reagent is wash solution. This wash solution is equal volume of sulfuric precipitant and alcohol are mixed together. These two reagents known as sulfuric precipitant and wash solutions are required for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium in face powder. Now we'll see the procedure for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium present in a face powder. So here a detailed procedure. Take approximately 2 gram face powder sample in petri dish and ignite it at 600 to 650 degrees centigrade to form a light gray ash. Transfer this ash into Erlenmeyer flask and add 100 ml sulfuric precipitant to the above flask and shake the flask vigorously. To this solution was allowed to stand overnight. Then the solution is filtered through filter paper to get filtrate and residue. So filtrate, which is known as filtrate A, is used for estimation of zinc present in face powder, and the residue which is obtained is known as residue A, which is washed with wash solution and used for estimation of calcium and magnesium. So this way we get a filtrate and residue from the face powder sample. So the filtrate obtained was used for estimation of zinc and residue obtained is used for the estimation of the calcium. The whole process here is shown in the colorful pictorial format. So this is the face powder which is taken in petri dish. When this was ignited at 600 to 650 degrees centigrade, it formed a light gray ash. This ash was transferred into a Erlenmeyer flask containing sulfuric precipitant, and in that 100 ml sulfuric precipitant was added. The flask was shaken vigorously and then it was allowed to stand overnight. In this flask, a precipitate was formed which was filtered through filter paper to get a filtrate A and residue A. This residue A is used for estimation of calcium and magnesium, and the obtained filtrate A is used for estimation of zinc. So this process for getting a filtrate and residue from the face powder, which can be used for estimation of calcium, magnesium and zinc. Here we will see first the determination of zinc from filtrate A. To the above class containing filtrate A, which is obtained by previous method, we have to add a methyl red indicator, HCl and water, and this solution have to be boiled on hot plate. To this solution, then add 60 ml diammonium hydrogen phosphate and boil it continue for 30 minutes. Then the reaction mixture was allowed to cool at room temperature and then filter through previously made crucible. So here then the obtained precipitate of zinc pyrophosphate is washed with 1% diammonium hydrogen phosphate and then with 50% alcohol. This residue of zinc pyrophosphate was dried and then ignited at full heat to get constant weight of zinc oxide. Whatever the weight of zinc oxide we get from zinc pyrophosphate or zinc oxide, we can calculate the weight or percentage of zinc present in the waste product. So by using this procedure, we can calculate the amount of zinc present in waste powder. Whole process is shown here in colorful picture. Here is a flask which containing filtrate A, which is obtained by previous procedure. To this flask, add a methyl red, HCl, water, and boil it on hot plate. This is a boiled solution of filtrate A, methyl red and water. In that, add 60 ml diammonium hydrogen phosphate and boil it further for 30 minutes. We'll get the precipitate. Then this mixture was allowed to cool at room temperature and then filter through previously wet crucible. We'll get the precipitate of zinc pyrophosphate. This precipitate of zinc pyrophosphate is washed with 1% diammonium hydrogen phosphate and finally with 50% alcohol to get a precipitate of zinc pyrophosphate, which was ignited at full heat to get zinc oxide. So by weighing the zinc oxide, we can calculate the amount of zinc or percentage of zinc present in a waste powder. So this whole process is explaining how we can calculate or estimate the amount of zinc present in a waste powder. Next, we'll see the determination of calcium and magnesium from residue A, which was obtained by previous method. So, the residue A obtained from cooling precipitant is taken in petri dish and then burned at 650 degrees centigrade to form ash. To this ash, 1:9 HCl, methyl red and ammonium hydroxide is added. Further, 200 mg of ammonium sulfate and bromine is added to destroy excess of indicator. Again, excess of bromine is removed by boiling. To this solution was made alkaline by adding ammonium hydroxide and then filtered through a filter paper to get filtrate and residue. residue is discarded here and filtered, which is known as a filtered B, is used to determine calcium and magnesium. This picture shows the part of procedure of determination of calcium and magnesium. So here is the residue A obtained from pulping precipitant. This residue A is taken in petri dish and burned at 650 degrees centigrade to form a ash. This ash is then transferred into a beaker in which 1:9 HCl, methyl red and ammonium hydroxide was added. To this beaker, then 200 mg of ammonium sulfate and bromine is added to destroy excess of methyl red indicator. This solution was then boiled further to remove excess of bromine. The resulting solution is made alkaline by adding ammonium hydroxide, will get a precipitate. This precipitate was filtered through a filter paper to get a filtrate and residue. The obtained residue was discarded and the obtained filtrate, which is known as filtrate B, is used to determine calcium and magnesium. So this picture clearly explains the process of determination of calcium and magnesium. So here is the procedure for determination of calcium from the filtrate B. To this obtained filtrate B, ammonium oxalate solution is added to get calcium oxalate precipitate. This precipitate is dissolved in distilled water containing 25 cm³ of 14 normal H2SO4. Then it is heated at 70 degrees centigrade. And then it is titrated with 0.1 normal KNO4 solution. From the constant burette reading of this titration, we can calculate the weight or percentage of calcium present in the face powder. By using this process, we can estimate the amount of calcium present in the face powder. The whole process is shown here in a colorful picture. This is a filtered B which is obtained by a previous method. This filtered B is transferred to a flask and in that ammonium oxalate solution is added. The calcium present in a sample gets precipitated as a calcium oxalate. This calcium oxalate precipitate is filtered through a flask. This calcium oxalate precipitate is then dissolved in water and in that 25 ml of 14 normal H2SO4 is added and this solution is heated at 70 degrees centigrade and the obtained solution is then titrated with 0.1 normal KNO4 solution. So from the constant burette reading of this titration, we can calculate the amount of calcium present in a face powder. So this is how we can calculate or estimate the amount of calcium present in a face powder. Next, we'll see the determination of magnesium present in a face powder from filtrate B. To the above filtrate B, add 1:1 HCl, 2 to 3 gram of ammonium hydrogen phosphate, followed by 1:1 HCl to get clear solution. This solution is made alkali by adding ammonium hydroxide and then allow stand for 2 to 3 hours. The solution was then filtered to get residue of MgP2O7, that is magnesium pyrophosphate. This residue of magnesium pyrophosphate was washed with 1:1 ammonium hydroxide till free from chloride. The precipitate of magnesium pyrophosphate is then ignited in a porcelain crucible at full heat till constant weight of magnesium oxide is obtained. So by knowing the weight of magnesium pyrophosphate or magnesium oxide, we can calculate the weight or percentage of magnesium present in the face powder. So this is the procedure to calculate the amount of magnesium present in a face powder. This whole procedure can show in a colorful picture. So this is a filtrate B which is obtained by the previous method. This filtrate B is transferred to a flask. In this flask, add 1:1 HCl, 2 to 3 gram of ammonium hydrogen phosphate, and you will get the clear solution. To this clear solution, you have to add ammonium hydroxide and then you have to allow it to stand for 2 to 3 hours. You will get the precipitate of magnesium pyrophosphate. This precipitate is filtered through the crucible and it was washed with 1:1 ammonium hydroxide. Then this precipitate of magnesium pyrophosphate is ignited in porcelain crucible to get a magnesium oxide. This magnesium oxide was wet. And from weight of the magnesium oxide, we can calculate the amount of magnesium or percentage of magnesium present in a face powder. So this is the procedure by which we can estimate the amount of zinc present in a face powder. So dear student, in this module, up to now, you have learned about reagents required for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium in face powder, and you have also learned about procedure for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium present in face powder. So for a time being, I am saying you goodbye. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please see the uploaded e-study material of this topic for further understanding. Please submit the uploaded assignment of this topic within given time, and also please provide us your valuable feedback and suggestion about this video. This e-learning module was prepared with support, motivation and encouragements of Honorable Principal Dr. Ganesh Thakur Sahib, ex-secretary, Raj Shikshan Sanstha Satara, and Principal Mahatma Phule, Arts, Science and Commerce College, Panvel. I wish you all a happy self-learning.